Army recruiters have apparently been told not to hire as many men. News Corp is reporting defence recruiters have been warned they'll be penalised if they don't pick women to fill most jobs. It's a hot topic this morning. To discuss it, we're joined by the Herald Sun's Susie O'Brien in Melbourne and Chris Smith from 2GB and 4BC. Susie, let's start with you. Should the Army be recruiting more women at the expense of men?
Well, you know, the Army should be recruiting the best person for the job, but why can't we assume that the best person for the job doesn't come from an all-female talent pool? For years and years, they've been hiring only men, and no one's been complaining about not having the best person for the job. So I say that when you've got 12% of people in the Army who are female, then clearly they need to readdress the balance. And hiring only women, surely the talent pool of women putting themselves forward for Army jobs is rich and full of talented women who meet the criteria, and I have every confidence in thinking that the best person for the job can come from an all-female talent pool. And with only 12% of women, the Army's really got no choice.
Yeah, Chris, it opens up this whole, you know, question of quotas, and maybe in years gone by, they haven't been recruiting the best person for the job, have they? Because they've obviously got a lot of men.
Well, we don't know that, and the fact that there's 12% women in an organisation like the military doesn't necessarily say there's discrimination. It may have been a case that there haven't been as many women putting their hands up. I hate this stuff. I hate this affirmative action rubbish where you create more resentment than anything else, because some of the women will then realise that they've been put into these positions because, well, they only pulled from a female talent pool, so I wasn't up against the best for the job.
And then women don't think like that. Chris, well, men think like that. Well, women in those positions won't think that.
Well, but don't they want to be put in on performance and merit and not on their sex?
But why are you assuming that an all-female talent pool isn't going to mean that women are put in the place because of their talent and
their performance? Because there's no men there.
But why do you assume that men are going to be better than women?
No, I'm not assuming anything. I want the best person for the job. This is dangerous stuff.
You're assuming the best person from the job couldn't be from an all-female talent pool, and that's exactly why they need these sorts of quotas.
No, you're skewing this. At the end of the day, it's the best for the job. Merit and performance. This is too dangerous work. Don't social engineer this stuff. The public won't cop it.
The public will have known the outcome of the Royal Commission into a sexual assault in the Defence Forces, and they know that one of the biggest reasons for this is the toxic culture in the Defence Forces, and one of the ways to address that is to have more women, and that's exactly what they need to do.
That's not one of the ways to address it. I disagree, absolutely. It creates resentment, and all of a sudden you've got men versus women and people being put into positions based on their gender, their genitalia.
It only creates resentment amongst men who think they're missing out when they have been hired because they're men for years and years.
Well, that's untrue. I don't agree with it at all. And the problem is, as soon as Labor gets in, when the Liberal Party's out, we're going to get more of this rubbish. Lots of it. Bowen made a big speech at the National Press Club recently. We're going to get more of this rubbish, and it's rubbish. It's social engineering. We don't need it.
More women hired because they can do a job. Well, no wonder men are resentful.
No, more women hired because they're women. This is
women
what they're trying
to... only be hired in the Defence Forces if they could do the job. You think someone in the Army is going to be putting a woman on the frontline combat role if she can't actually do the job? That's absurd.
Let's
it's absolutely
the right
absurd
person.
For you to
Why
suggest
Why are we
that.
Worrying about their gender? Why?
Well, because there's only 12% of women, and clearly that's an unhealthy environment.
Well, I disagree.
And as you say, Susie, some of those scandals have proven that. Okay.